Hi everybody, it's Kirsty Mickey from Naio Nails. In this video we are going to continue the fire design that I'm doing. We're going to do a 3D using the awesome 3D sculpting gel. So for this nail we are going to do 3D flames because it's all about the fire.
Fire!
I love doing a full look. I get more excited about full looks. So I've just put on dehydrator and then primer. So for this nail, I'm going to sculpt out entirely with pure red. So I'm going to work with the free edge first because that won't set as quick. I know you're thinking, but you're doing it first, so it's going to set quick. No, it won't, because it's not on a living person. This part is not touching this part. The heat from the finger helps the product to set up quicker. So, because this isn't on her nail plate, it won't set as quick. Tipping the finger down as I do the cuticle area. And into this nail, I'm going to press in some glitters. So this one is called Tickle Me Pink Chunky Glitter. And look at that, it immediately makes it look like fire because it's got the right tones and colours. It says it's pink, but on top of red, look what it looks like. It's awesome. And we've got a bit of wine knot, as in wine knot. For this one, I'm going to pick up a little bit of clear, press it into the glitter, and then pull it all the way over the nail. I think this combination is good for Christmas as well.
Ooh.
It's nice for Christmas.
It's like the sparkly Christmas party stuff.
And then we're going to encapsulate with clear. If you were doing a full set just like this, what you could do is apply the glitter, you know, the red and then the glitter onto all of them. So you could do the red on all, the glitter on all, and then encapsulate them all. You wouldn't have to do each one at a time. Ooh, nearly put the glitter lid onto the product. Nearly put it onto the acrylic. It would have had a very glittery acrylic. Oh, it's quite nice, actually. I'm just going to pinch this nail now. I'm going to pinch the very end as well, the tip with my fingers. Right, I'm going to take off the foam now because we're going to file this nail and then we're going to do the 3D flames. So side walls, cuticle area, then contour the top surface. I'm going to buff this now, make it all smooth so we can see all that fabulous glitter. This video is like a 2-for-1. You get to see how to do a full colour glittered nail using acrylic and glitter, and you also get to see how to create 3D flames.
A twofer.
I say you buy one, you get one free. Going to wipe over with acetone Wow. Goddamn, goddamn. I'm going to apply mega gloss to this. Want to work on top of a shiny surface. My God, it is so shiny. That is just spectacular. Pop that into the lamp for me. Now this stuff is magnificent. Magnifico! So we have orange and we have red 3D sculpting gel. Oh my God, this stuff is life itself. You need it in your life. If you haven't got it, I don't feel sorry for you because you just need to go and buy it right now. I'm going to get some of the red and we're going to take out some of the orange. Less orange though. Cover your pots up. And then with clean fingers, we're going to get that. We're going to roll it like Play-Doh. Give it a bit of a twist. Oh, I like it already. I'm going to pop that onto the nail. Oh, it looks like a candy cane.
I thought you were going to say, and I'm done.
And there you are.
That doesn't quite look how I thought it was going to look.
Is it not what you thought? No. Oh. Or maybe I need to work it a little bit.
Right.
Working, baby.
We're going to work it. So I'm going to attach it at the cuticle nice and neat. I may have too much on here. And then what we're going to do is start to press. I'm going to cut half of this off. What I'm going to do is sort of fold, create these folds as if they are flames cascading up the nail. In my dampened dish, I have the gel residue wipe off solution. That's going to help the brush not stick. It's basically like a non-sticky solution. You want to come to a point at the end. Then where your curves are here, you're going to break that and bring them to a point. Like this. So break that with the tip of your brush. And fold it into a point like that. And the same here. So this isn't like acrylic, it's not setting as we use it. We can just keep playing with it. So there are the first sets of flames and we're going to keep adding to this. Pop it in the lamp. Give it a cure. You've got to cure that before you go on to your next set of flames. So with the piece that we cut off, I'm going to roll that. Then we're going to cut off what we're going to use. Come on, get it. I'm going to pat and press this into little right, flames. Little. Oh, I like it. What I'm going to do is feed in some stones. Some crystals. Sorry, got to be done. I am just going to wipe over with gel residue wipe-off solution. Just in the little nooks and crannies. And then we're going to use a bit of mega gloss. I'm going to use a dotting tool for this.
Which one?
Big one won't go there. Big one will go there, though. Bigger one. Oh, yes. Oh yes, darling, I am loving this. Love, 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 love. Lovely. Pop that into the lamp for me. I'm going to finish with some cuticle oil. Oh, I love it. Oh, it feels really nice as well. Love it. Three flames. There you are, guys. Not as difficult as you think. I think you'll agree. Because it's not acrylic. The 3D sculpting gel is awesome for doing things like this. So have a go. Don't forget to check us out on Facebook and Instagram. And I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye-bye.